So I'm basically keeping my chat closed until the end of the presentation.
Yes, that's what I did. It makes it easier, you know, so you're not distracted by moving text.
Exactly.
I'm also.
Okay, great. I'm good.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to this afternoon. Okay. All right. Hello, everybody. Welcome to this afternoon's. Okay, I'm hearing myself talk. Okay, I'm also hearing it from the website too. Shoot, okay. Welcome again to this afternoon session. Breakout presentation about the Kitely market. Here we have today Ilan Tochner, the founder and CEO of Kitely. It is the largest commercial grid in the OpenSim platform with over 4,400 regions. It is different from other grids in that it offers on-demand cloud-based hosting and a range of very unique pricing plans. Ilan's previous startup, IDChoice, focused on detecting and preventing identity theft, and he brings that expertise with him to his current project. Before that, he was the director of infrastructure development at OmniSky, has an MBA from Tel Aviv University, and a Bachelor of Science in Computer Science from the Hebrew University of Jerusalem. He'll be talking to us today about the recent launch of the Kitely Market, a marketplace that allows merchants to sell goods to users in Kitely, and soon to users on other grids as well, with full control about whether the goods could leave the Kitely grid or not. Ilan, thank you very much for joining us here today.
Thank you, Maria. So let us begin. I'm going to talk to you today about the Metaverse marketplace, the Kitely market. Now, first, a few words about what it is, why we want it, and how exactly is it going to help us all. So our goal when we created the Kitely market was to create a virtual goods marketplace that will create a unified market out of all the separate grids that they connect to the hypergrid metaverse. This will enable content creators to make serious money while setting up only a single web-based store. Now, it's an ambitious project, and we've been working on it since the beginning of the year, and there's still a lot more to be done before we complete all our goals. But Kitely Market, if successful, will help finally create a critical mass of content merchants and buyers to help the metaverse evolve from this collection of standalones and small grids to a new unified market that can attract both serious investment, therefore bringing in serious VC money to actually help us grow and get additional development into the metaverse, and helping all the people that are currently looking at the metaverse and saying, well, you know, all of that, I just kind of get it in Second Life, I don't see the point. Helps them see that the OpenSim can offer a better alternative than just staying inside of Second Life. Now, so that's the what and the why, and then the question is the how. Okay, how are we going to achieve these goals? Now, when we designed Kitely Market, we had several examples in mind. We know that most users of virtual world are familiar with Second Life Marketplace, since it's the largest and most successful market for virtual goods. Therefore, we started by making sure that Kitely Market will look familiar to people coming from Second Life. For example, we arrange products in categories 3, and that has a lot in common with Second Life. However, that wasn't our goal wasn't to stop there. Our goal wasn't to just copy Second Life Marketplace. It was to create something better. So we continued by adopting some good ideas from popular e-commerce sites such as Amazon. For example, we added attributes. These are all things I'm going to discuss in a few more slides that make it easier for you to find what you want. And so, therefore, to give you an experience where you can actually, when you're using the site, to say, well, this is better than Second Life Marketplace as a user and as a merchant. And then you say, okay, if OpenSim has this better alternative, then maybe OpenSim is a serious place that we all want to start using, because it isn't this, you know, a collection of things that look like it came from 2006 and 2007, which is one of the things that people say from Second Life users say about OpenSim. We want it to look like it's better. And one of the places that has the most attracts the most basically eyeballs, money, involvement in Second Life is a Second Life Marketplace. So in order to get that into OpenSim, we had to create something which was better than what Second Life has. Okay, so we did all that, and we actually added a few more of our original ideas, and you can see that discussed later. Okay, so let's begin. Okay, this is how the basic screen, the first thing you might see when you log into Kitely Market. Kitely Market, as I said, offers advanced search capabilities. Now, these are a lot of things you expect when you see you come from Second Life Marketplace or you came from Amazon. They're the features you would be familiar with. There are categories, there's a text search, there are stores. There's something additional here that I want to discuss, and let me just tell you a short story. I had an idea. I woke up and I remembered there was such a store, and I couldn't remember the exact name. But here, I called it was North Carolina, so Carolina. So I searched that, and then I got options, and I opened the store page. That up to now, that's pretty much Second Life Marketplace. Now I had a category tree, and there are all kinds of things in the category tree. If you look at Second Life category tree, you can find, for example, rings in 4 different places. You can find them under Valentine's, and you can find them under wedding, and you can find them in women's. And there's multiple places where you can find content in Second Life, which makes it really hard finding what the exact thing you're looking for. So instead of copying the Second Life marketplace content categories tree, we said, okay, let's change it to what things are and their attributes. So if something is, for example, clothing or clothing bundles or avatar accessories and so forth, those are categories. But things such as the color of the item or the clothing style, the department or the occasion, for example, it's a wedding or it's Valentine's or Halloween, and many other things are actually attributes. And once you start separating categories from attributes, it gives you a lot of power to do things such as, you see here the filters area, you see the filters bar, which when I choose a category, you can see the currently clothing category selected. I can start choosing filters. For example, I chose woman, and you see this appear on this filter bar. And I chose gray, and it's scrolled down so you can't see it, but I chose to see things that also allow me to copy and that are general or moderate rating. And so here I did all these filters, and these are the 3 results I was left with. And of course you have the sorting, which has all the, all the expected sort orders. You also have a rating system, which is advanced. You don't see it here, but there's multiple ways to rate and reviews and basically get an experience which is allows you to dig down and find content in a way that is much better than Second Life Marketplace. There are a few things that we just launched this. There are a few things we still want to fix to improve the experience to make it even better. But you can already, once you play with it, see how it reacts and allows you to find what you're looking for much, much faster. Okay. Now, when you open a product, In Second Life, you open a product and you see, let's say, the same chairs. You can see multiple products for them. And so you'll see the different multiple items for all the colors, and you'll see multiple items for the demos. And it's a big mess getting from one to another or seeing all of them at once. Well, in Kitely Market, all the products and variations and the demos are located in the same listing. So for example, here you see this collection of chairs. And if you see, this is currently the selected, this is the selected chair, but I hovered my mouse over here on the red chairs. As I hover over the pictures, pictures quickly change. So I could quickly browse without having to actually click and change to the other product. And when I click to the other product, let's say I clicked on the on white, I was on black or on red, it would actually change, select it so I could actually add it to my cart. But when I move my mouse over between the different items, all the information, the description, the permissions, the items that are included, all of this would change as you quickly move. Now, this is something which seems like it's a small feature, but it actually makes it much easier to find what you're looking for and for merchants to attract customers with additional selling options. So, for example, these variations, they don't have to be separate products. They could be bundles. They could be, okay, buy all my chairs for a certain price, or you can get them in separate colors for different prices, for reduced prices. You can have certain things that you buy for Kitely credits and certain things you can only buy for, you can buy for dollars, for example, or you set some different permissions. And all of these different features made it very easy to use the marketplace. And of course, you have things that are linked and you can create a click on a username to get to your store and so forth. But all of these things that are intuitive, the thing is, and why can't I do that such and such? Well, in Kitely Market, you usually can. And if you can't, it's just because we haven't implemented it yet. Okay, so you can also see, you can easily share the content you're looking at with your social networks. And that, again, is a feature that you already expect. Now, there's something interesting. There's a lot of, as you can see, there are a lot of pictures here. Each variation is just showing a single image right now, but there are more images that the merchant added. And when you click that, you can actually see here, this is how it looks, the thing would get grayed out, and you'd see a bigger image, just didn't have a place to present it here, see a bigger image where you could actually quickly, and these images scroll by when you click these buttons, you quickly navigate between the various images, and I've seen products with more than 60 images, and quickly scroll between them. And if you like something that you see, which may be from a different variation, you can click here on the variation name, and it will change the product underneath the viewer. So you can go and look at that, at that product. Now, all of this is intended to create a much more intuitive and fun browsing experience. You go to a store and you quickly flip through items. Basically, it's kind of like what you would do with Pinterest, where you see a lot of pictures and then you can dig down into those pictures. So you don't have to discover content just through the listing where it has additional content or things might not be related to one another. You can do that here. In the image viewer. Now, there's a lot of information that Kitely adds automatic. So it's automatic in-depth information. For example, the permissions are automatically calculated when the merchant adds the content into Kitely Market. You don't have to trust that they're listing the correct thing. The system calculates that. In the background here, you can see, if I scroll down this window, which I did here when the thing is grayed out, when I selected the image viewer, you can see that you can actually see all the items that are contained and the items that contain, and you can see their permissions on the system. So all of these things allow you to quickly understand what it is you're looking for and what it is that you're going to buy. And since information is automatically added, it's going to be there, unlike in Second Life Marketplace where the merchant might add this information or it might not. It's very time consuming to add a lot of metadata. Okay, So I talked about a bit about the features, but the important part when we created Kitely Market wasn't just to create something that a destination, and then I got what I wanted to buy, but to also make shopping enjoyable, like it is in real life. So in order to do that, we've made Kitely Marketing provide the same type of user experience that you usually get only in mobile apps, as in things slide, rotate, fade in and out, grow and shrink, and provide all other sorts of engaging feedback. So just playing with the marketplace is fun. And this is all done in HTML5, and it works on OS and Linux, OS X and Linux, and Android and iOS and Windows, of course, and in various browsers, other than IE, below IE 9, we don't really support it. 9 and 10 we actually fall back to, not showing as many animations. But the goal here is basically to allow you to find things easily, enjoy the process, and therefore be a lot more attractive and likely to buy in this marketplace than you are actually even going to find the same things if you can in the Second Life marketplace. Okay, so I discussed a little bit about the features that are available for the buyer, but there are also a lot of things that are available for a seller. For example, when you buy something and when you set up a new item, you don't have to upload it via your inventory in world. This widget opens and you can create the product from the website entirely. So you don't have to go in world to upload items. You can select multiple items here, and they're automatically uploaded. They're uploaded in a way, by the way, that is, you can actually include folders. So you don't have to pack things in boxes. You can actually pack them in folders because Kitely Market direct delivers into people's inventories. The buyer, once it gets it, doesn't have to take an additional step into opening those delivered bot items. Now, you obviously have a lot of information, and these are just snippets from various screens that the merchant has access to. You have the purchase for you have a shopping cart where you can see easily, add additional things. You can see you easily buy via PayPal. Get that information for them. You have the sales information. You have various email notifications with pretty tables that provide you a lot of detailed information. Compare that to what you get with Second Life Marketplace. You'll see that the emails are much more friendly and informative. You have, of course, the sales history where you can redeliver items. You can redeliver a newer version of the items automatically to the users. You can refund. Refund only works in Kitely credits. I'll explain the monetary system, the billing system in a few slides. But you can refund payments for 40 days. You can see that the item was refunded. You can click, I can include a picture here, but if you click for a product, you see additional information about the product and the purchase. And products actually have versions. You don't see it in the interface, but you can have to, if you send multiple versions of the item over time, the links in your sales history will point to the real, to the version of what was bought at the time. So if the price changed, or the items change and so forth, you'll be able to see this in your sales history. And the purchase history the buyer has as well. So there's everyone has this access to this data. And there are a lot of other additional features that you do need to play with the product to understand. I don't want to spend too much time talking about them. One of the important features that we just added on Friday to the marketplace was a powerful content analyzer. We found that sometimes you have content delivery problems. A lot of the times, it's because there's something wrong with the product. And when you looked at the screen, you saw that we have a deliver product and deliver a test delivery link and so forth in the marketplace. And actually, when you do test delivery, our system automatically changes it to the Kitely Market avatar that delivers it to you. So if you're the owner and testing deliver, you will see the permissions as your buyer would see them. Now, one of the things that we saw that the a lot of various problems exist in content. So there's a missing assets because people forgot to change UIDs and scripts and then upload things. And there are invisible things that the people have forgot to delete and so forth. And so here you see on this screen, if you scroll down in the product listing, the edit mode of product listing, which the merchant has access to, you can see that we actually give notes. We actually give notes here when there are problems. These are just found to warnings in this case. And we allow you to deliver a debug version of the content to your inventory. Now you can then res, go in world and res the items that you want with the debug item next to it. And which the things that are have problems will be highlighted in red. So you can find which items are reference these exclamation marks here, basically means that there are problems with your product, and there's a, actually they're quite detailed. They tell you and the path to get to the product and then what the problem is. But it's hard from the from that path to find the product in world. So we've created this deliver debug version, which highlights the content so you can easily find what we're talking about. For example, this prim is an invisible prim, so you can't see it here in this actual product. But once you see that it's invisible, you know where to capture it, and you can delete, and you can set, in this case it was missing a texture, but you can actually delete it. Now, this feature prevents, we have warnings and errors, and if there's an error in the product, it will actually not allow you to activate the product. When you do a list, when you change a product, you have, you can you have a live version of the product, and you can edit the version and have that edited for a long time, and things are auto-saved until you activate the product, and then it's, it replaces the previous version that was active on the marketplace. So this feature, the content analyzer, allows you to track and make sure that the content you're going to offer inside of Kitely and to other places will not be broken. This reduces the amount of support that you're going to have to provide your buyers, and which will make everyone happy. People who buy content get content that works and isn't broken, and people who sell content have to do a lot less support. Okay. So now getting to the, a bit to the money. There's flexible sales options. You can sell for Kitely credits, which are non-convertible currency. They're not, you can't convert them into real money. You can't trade them for real money. This is not going to change. There are play money. You can use them for in-world inside of Kitely and a Kitely market in certain places if the merchant decided that he wishes to accept Kitely credits. A merchant doesn't have to accept Kitely credit. He can say, I only want to accept real dollars. They can be used to pay Kitely for the actual, they can be used to pay Kitely for its own services. However, the merchant, obviously people want to earn real money for the content to buy, so the merchant can just list things for US dollars instead of relying on any virtual currency, Linden dollars or some small OpenSim currency or a third party currency, just all using dollars, because that anyone can buy that. There's no liquidity problem. You don't have to trust Kitely to exist tomorrow. And then basically you get money without having to convert anyway. And so the merchant can select what currencies he wishes to accept. He wishes to price things for Kitely credits, he wishes to price them in US dollars, or he can price them in US dollars and allow people to buy Kitely credits as well if they have them. And whatever the user pays, the buyer pays, that's the currency we're going to give you, the merchant. Now, you can, a merchant can select to create content that can remain only inside of Kitely using an export feature, export flag, it's actually export tracking system that we created. It's different from the export system that's currently being pushed by Avi Nations. It's not viewer side, it's controlled completely inside the Kitely market. Every item that you buy inside of Kitely from the Kitely market is tracked from that point on until it leaves the Kitely grid. So even if it's res, copied, renamed, moved to other people's inventory, so forth, we know which transaction it came from. So if there's a problem with the transaction, we can, first off, what we already do is there's a problem with transaction, we stop it from being exportable at that moment, even if it is allowed to be exportable. Eventually we'll implement that it will actually take back items. So if there's a problem, if you didn't pay the merchant or the merchant refunded the money to you because you asked him to, the item is going to disappear from any place that it got happened to. So it won't, so if the merchant doesn't get money, you don't get to keep the item. Now, one of the things that this entire marketplace is built to support is the growth of the entire metaverse. So a feature that's really coming soon, this is still not implemented, is that things that merchants are set to allow export will be deliverable via a hypergrid delivery mechanism to any hypergrid-enabled grid that allows or just doesn't go out and just block us. So if you don't block us, your users will be able to buy content from Kitely Market and have it delivered to them inside your grid. And they don't have to go enrolled in Kitely to get that. They don't have to be Kitely users. You have to have a Kitely user to check out just the payment information, but you don't have to ever go enrolled inside Kitely. It becomes like Amazon. They deliver. If you want to get our content from us, all you have to do is not block us. If you have a closed good, all you have to do is create an exception for the Kitely Market delivery mechanism. If you do that, we can deliver to your grid. Okay, moving on. Okay, so this is a bit of a question of why a new marketplace. Currently, we're in a state where people don't use OpenSim because they can't find content, and merchants don't want to sell to OpenSim because there's no one to sell to. They say, you know, it's not worth the trouble. There'll be copy buttons, there'll be a lot of things. It's not worth the risk. I just won't go there. And there, this creates a circle that's very hard to break, unless you create a unified market which can attract both merchant buyers, money, and activity and interest to everyone. So once you create this sort of hub for economic activity, then the buyers know where to go to get content, merchants know where to go to sell content, and then you create this cycle that attracts more and more merchants and more buyers. And we have already seen this with Kitely out in less than a week out. We're already seeing growth in the number of transactions and the number of merchants starting to create listings. Okay, so the goal here is to help the OpenSim grow. In order for any OpenSim company to succeed, we need the entire ecosystem to grow. Even the biggest OpenSim-based grid is hardly investable from a VC point of view. And if we want to get real money here, to really move things forward, to get the good improvement browsers, to get things running on tablets and mobile devices, to get integration with Oculus Rift, to get all the nice things we all want to get, we need to create momentum. And in order to create momentum, we need to get money into the system. And then you get money by unifying everyone around a market. It's not a marketplace, it's a market, because the merchants are not the marketplace. They want to earn money, they get it wherever they can, if it's convenient. Buyers don't have to be in Kitely. They go to whatever grid they want. They want to go shopping and basically get the content they want delivered to whatever grid they're on, and then they use that. But in order for any traction to be created, we have to create something which has a critical mass. And that simply didn't exist until now. And we hope that the Kitely Market will help that evolve. Okay, so during this past week, there have been a lot of questions and objections in the blogosphere about Kitely Market. So hopefully you get this reference, what this relates to. Now I'm going to talk about some of those objections and what our answers are to them. Then I'm going to do a quick what's ahead slide, and then I'm going to take questions. Okay, so how I learned to stop worrying and love Kitely Market. So this is the first objection people have. People will steal my content. Well, the general narrative going on in Second Life is that people are already stealing your content in OpenSim. This is not that you don't have to have Kitely Market for that. They take it, they rip it off from Second Life, and it's uploaded into OpenSim, and then it's there. So if you're successful, people are already using it, but you're just not getting paid for it. So we looked at, if you look at what the music industry did, and remember Napster, and it's extremely easy to get the illegal copied of songs online. But iTunes sells you songs for 99 cents showed that if you create a good enough marketplace, it will enable you to get money from people who can easily steal your content in other places. So the goal is to make it such that people say, well, I could maybe find a copy about it content, but then first maybe the legal issues, and then it might be a hassle, and I might not want to be involved with these kind of people, and all of this is going to be time consuming, so I might as well go to Kitely Market and buy it. It's convenient and simple, and since it's affordable, I'll be done. It's automatically delivered to whatever grid I'm on. Everyone's happy. And the merchant suddenly got a sale from someone who would otherwise just have either stolen their content with a lot of hassle, or just have bought someone else's content. So it's a sale that either exists for the merchant or doesn't exist, making it available in a marketplace that can actually deliver to OpenSim users in a convenient way for both the OpenSim user and the merchant, enables the sale to exist. Okay, well, then the next question is, well, I already sell in the Second Life Marketplace. People can move my content to OpenSim, so why should I use Kitely Market? Well, it comes to convenience. Is delivering to an OpenSim-based grid automatic? It isn't. You have to copy it and then upload it and hope for it works okay, and sometimes you have to contact the merchant. And this is time consuming, and this whole thing, and instead of pressing a button and having it delivered, you're now spending, luckily, tens of minutes. We had some people who bought content that they wanted to get into Kitely, take days until the entire cycle was complete. So it requires time, and it requires, and it's inconvenient, and so basically, if you're only saying, well, I already have a presence in Second Life Marketplace, then our reply is, if you want to make the sale, make it easier to get your content legally than to steal it. And even if this person won't steal it, they'll just buy someone else's content that is available in a convenient place. So you're losing sales, maybe not to everyone, that some people are willing to go through this process. But now that Kitely Market exists, and once we start delivering to other grids as well, it's going to be, am I going to spend a lot of time and effort to buy from your Second Life Marketplace store, or am I just going to go to Kitely Market and buy something I can get in minutes or in seconds once I press the button? And so you just make it easier to get your content legally than steal it. Okay, then the objection of, well, copy brothers will sell my items in Kitely Market. One of the things about Kitely, and if you remember, and it provides information that I didn't mention before, is that since Kitely doesn't have a convertible virtual currency, it only has real money, and the only place you can sell in Kitely in real money is the Kitely Market, then in order to sell something on Kitely Market, you have to sell it in the marketplace where it's visible basically to anyone. So if you just, since there are a lot less items showing because we group items together, it's very simple for well-known content creators to just sort by newest and find and see if their items were added, or just get called like they do now in Second Life Marketplace, where people say, well, you know, this so-and-so started selling rip-offs of your content, and they take it down. The same people who are going to point you out that someone ripped you off in the Second Life Marketplace will do so in Kitely Market. But in Kitely Market, they'll have to browse for a lot less items because we group things together. And Kitely Market also has the way the payouts work is that we have a 45-day payout delay that serves two purposes. First, it gets us past the PayPal dispute window. PayPal has a 45-day dispute window on money paid through PayPal. So after that point, we can transfer you money, and if there's a chargeback or something, We don't claw back the money from you. You already got money. We'll take it out of future earnings from your marketplace. So you don't have to deal with chargebacks. You don't have to deal with PayPal. We hold the money until we feel it safe. We get to put a 45-day payout delay, and then on a weekly schedule, whatever money was collected, basically 45 days prior to that, will be delivered to you. And since this 45-day delay also offers another advantage, it makes it very hard for someone to profit from selling in Kitely markets without getting caught, because the 45 days, if they should be selling something for which is probably, if they get any significant amount of money, someone's going to see it. And then if they tell us about it in the 45 days since the first purchase was made, then we won't transfer money to that copywriter. And we can actually transfer the money to the actual person whose content that belongs to. So basically, if you're a copywriter trying to sell through Kitely Market, you have much better avenues. You'll get much more money out of Second Life, InWorld, and all kinds of places which are hard to attack until you sell for a few days and you disappear from money, which turns Linden dollars into US dollars. Or if you're trying to sell in Second Life marketplace, it will be harder to find you there. People might eventually find you, but they won't have this 45-day delay for getting money out. Okay, so the next thing. Well, merchants won't. This is something we're hearing from other grid owners, and this is there are various questions of this sort. Well, we'll start with the first one. Merchants won't get land on my grid. Well, marketplaces work. Because both buyers and sellers want to. So everything about Kitely markets, they exist. They're going to exist because they're a good idea, because both sides that want to transact want this technology, the service to exist. And most major grids are already embracing marketplaces, either develop themselves or allowing a third party to provide those services for them. Yes, Second Life, InWorld, and those, they all have marketplaces. And they all still have people renting land from them. And what one of the things Kitely is going to actually do is that we're going to create a Kitely Market affiliate program. So if someone buys, one of your users buys from you, and we deliver to that user, you're going to get a revenue share from that transaction. So unlike if they just go to the hypergrid, get something from another grid, and come back, and you don't get anything from that, and in which case they could be traveling to other grids that have shopping districts that you could say were hurting your land sales or your renting to merchants in your own grid. Well, unlike that, with Kitely Market, if there's a transaction in Kitely Market with one of your users, you get a revenue share from that. So even small grids who can't afford to have a marketplace or don't have a marketplace can profit from Kitely Market existing. And this is actually, when we did the math, this will probably be more profitable for some of the grids I've actually mentioned here. Running your own marketplace has, you have to deal with all kinds of cases of people trying to rip you off or leave you holding the bag while they use stolen credit cards or other things. You have the operation costs and so forth. Our revenue share will probably make it more profitable for even grids that currently have a marketplace to just point their users to Kitely Market. They'll certainly earn more and have a lot less headache for it. Okay, so the next slide. Well, all my users will move to Kitely. If you people have to buy Kitely credits, they might as well stay in Kitely. Well, merchants want to earn real money and not Kitely credits. And even items listed for Kitely credits can be bought directly using US dollars. We might just add an item to your shopping cart that turns, like in Second Life Marketplace, that turns the amount of Kitely credits you need into basically you buy the amount of credits you need for that transaction. So you don't have to get Kitely credits. You can go into Kitely and build inside a free access sandbox. There's no time limit to those. If those become crowded, we'll just open more of them. Free access for merchants, and basically build there, and you don't have to spend Kitely credits. Basically, the only cost you have is we have a small listing fee of 100 Kitely credits. That's about 33 cents when you create a new product, and you can change it as many times as you want. And when you add a new product variation, we take 25 Kitely credits which is like 8 cents. So this is extremely small fees, and the goal of those listing fees, by the way, is to limit the amount of spammy, low-quality content from entering the market. We want this to be a place where merchants can sell because there isn't a lot of spam, and buyers can find what they want because there isn't a lot of spam. So by adding this small fee, even if though it's pretty insignificant, if you do the cost of how many products you have, how much it costs to list, you see that even if you have a lot of items, this is not going to cost a lot. But this adds a barrier to spamming. The goal is to keep this a better experience at Second Life Marketplace. Okay, so next. Kitely's high-quality delivery system enables merchants to sell to any grids that want their content. If you want this content to exist on your grid, just don't block Kitely's hyper-grid delivery mechanism. You'll have the same content that anyone else can get that the merchants want to sell. And merchants want to sell to as many people as possible, so once they get used to the system, they're likely to make more things exportable. Okay, well, all of my users will move to Kitely because no export content only works in Kitely. Well, we can't force anyone to sell to other grids, but we will be making a change that merchants will be able to allow no export content to be used in other secure grids. So if you're running a closed grid and you have merchants that want to sell to your grid, and you want them to be able to do that, and they want to be able to continue selling to you, and they want to use a Kitely market, and you want to get that revenue share because in-world currency exchange rates are probably lower than what you're going to get from Kitely market. So you just be contact me directly, and we'll talk and see once we announce the details of this program. Then you'll be able to connect, and no export items will be deliverable if the merchant says they want to allow that to your grid as well. This won't be on a per grid basis. We'll basically have a white list of secure grids, and the merchant will be able to say, I want to allow and no export to other secure grids as well or not. And if they allow them, then any no export items that they have will be exportable to your grid as well if you're on that white list. Okay. Well, all my users moved to Kitely because Kitely gives cheap land. Well, to answer that, we've been out selling cheap land since 2011, and other grids have continued to prosper. And people like the communities, and some people don't want always on. Do want always on, and we're an on-demand grid. And so your users are not just going to come up and leave because there's a marketplace out there. There are already marketplaces out there. They're not going to leave because there's shopping districts out there. If you're hypergrid enabled, they're already traveling to other hypergrid shopping grids. They're going to stay your users because you offer them something that they don't get in Kitely. And a lot of people say there's not a lot of community. Well, we do have a small community, but we don't have a land mass. We have more than 4,400 regions, but they're in separate islands. And so we have our uses, but it's not for everyone. And so not everyone is going to go to Kitely. Okay.
We don't want you in our grid. Keep the marketplace for Kitely only. Well, that wouldn't provide the benefits for your unified market, that more merchants, buyers, money, activity, and interest for everyone. Remember, we did this because we wanted to grow the market, so this would become a field that grows quickly. It needs to have money coming in. This can't happen if we stay separated and there is no big single ecosystem to serve. Okay, so why didn't you reach out to grid owners? We've been openly discussing our plans on our blog, in Hypergrid Business, on other people's blogs have been written about it. And we've been involving the community in the science and the design decision since January 2013. Now, we thought that the benefits of a unified market were so self-evident, and discussing our plans in open is the greatest form of transparency. We don't do backroom deals with anyone. We discussed it out in the open. Anyone could give feedback. A lot of people did give feedback. We were contacted by people who previously created alternatives to the Second Life Marketplace. Several of them were quite successful at their time. We talked to big merchants. Anyone who wanted to talk to us, we've talked to. We've broadcast our plans for almost a year now. For 9 months now. And we're not closing the door on anyone. If you want to talk to us, by all means, please talk to us. We'll be happy to address your concern. And if there are things you think we should improve or change or add, then please let us know, because this is not just to serve our needs. This is to grow the entire ecosystem. This is not going to happen unless we all join together to create a single ecosystem. Okay, so this is just the last one before we get to my last slide. So, okay, so who died and made you king? This marketplace shouldn't be owned by any one company. Well, first off, we're kind of marketed sphere. We'll deliver to any grid that doesn't block us. And second, there are other multi-grid marketplaces out there. There's OpenSim Creation, OpenSim City, Hypergrid Exchange, Kariyama existed. We're not blocking anyone from doing the same. If you want to build something competing, go ahead. So it's already competition out there. The thing is that there's two ways of having a monopoly. Either you're the only one out there, which we're not, or you control our transactions, which I would like to think that a lot of transactions would go through us, but I think you would all agree that even Second Life Marketing, it's not that nothing only goes through one marketplace. So that's our question to that. No one chose us. We saw a need. We addressed it. If you think you can do better, go ahead. Okay, so that's coming soon, and then I get to the questions. Delivered to have a grid connected grids. That's great. I've talked about it a lot. Advanced discount system. This is like Steam, for those of you who use Steam, where you can have various sales and other things that will allow you to basically increase sales. And we want to make this the best virtual world marketplace out there. So OpenSim will have the best virtual world ecosystem, and we'll be able to draw serious money. We have want to add a contest system. As there is already contests in some marketplaces, but we have a few interesting ideas how to innovate in that area as well. And we want to add business intelligence tools so merchants will be able to understand what their buyers want, what they're currently buying, what's failing, what's working in their stores and in general in the market. Okay, and with that, I'm going to get to this. We're in the questions.
Okay, Ilan, we're kind of running late. We're past the end point of this topic. So I'm just going to ask a couple of quick questions that you didn't address. The big one that wasn't covered in your presentation that people were asking was, what percentage commission does Kitely take on sales?
Okay, there are two types of sales. There are sales in Kitely credits, which don't really interest most of you, I guess. But on those, Kitely takes 10% commission. And there's, remember, this can only be used basically to buy things inside of Kitely and paying Kitely for its own services. And for US dollars transactions, we take 20%. Then we transfer the money to you, and PayPal might take whatever PayPal takes. But these transactions, we have a minimum payment amount of $10. So you're not going to be nickel and dime by PayPal. We'll aggregate them and then transfer it to you when it's more substantial to pass those $10. We had a lot of discussion with our Kitely Mentors group about what level to set this. The reason we're at 20%, if you do the math in Second Life Marketplace, you can see that if you do the exchange fees, exchange rate for both the buyer and the seller and the marketplace transactions, and the checkout fees, and you do all the collection together, you get to that 20%. You can do the math later. Especially if they're buying directly in US dollars, which is what we allow. People buy, if you want to get dollars out, they buy with dollars. And with dollars, they have additional, they give you not as well, the exchange rate you get for dollars to lend in dollars is lower than what you can buy them separately, and so forth. So 20% is actually on the low end for most marketplaces outside of the OpenSim, Second Life, Ecosphere. If you look at the Cloud Party, it takes 20%. If you look at the Turbo Squid, they take 40 to 60%, 20 to 60%. So, and the various app stores take 40% usually.
Okay, and one last question: the take the take back feature, when you take content back from buyers, is that going to work across the hypergrid and with other grids too? And how would that work?
It, inside of Kitely, it works because we have Kitely market in one of its one of the questions I was asked about identity theft and fraud, but we track everything. We have logs coming from out of Wazoo. And so we are able to, we actually add metadata. So we deliver updates and we'll be able to eventually actually auto-update content in your inventory and even content already evolving. But delivery to other systems, initially when it's just via hypergrid, we won't be able to claw back content, obviously. We don't control other inventories, but we may eventually develop a system that will allow them to run a component which will allow our system to interact with them. So if they want this ability to be under grid as well, they'll be able to have access to it as well.
Okay. Ilan, I want to thank you very much for taking the time to talk to everybody here. If you don't mind, can you give an email address where people can contact you with follow-up questions? I have to go to another session to moderate about the future of the hypergrid. Okay. And there's your email address. I just type my email address into chat if anybody wants to ask me follow-up questions. Ilan's email address is right up there. You guys can stick around, but I have to run. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody, for coming. Thank you, AvaCon, for organizing this. And thank you, Ilan, for taking so much time to explain this in such depth. Thank you very much.
My pleasure. And if anyone has any questions, by all means, do contact me via email, via our phones, or using any other means. You can even private message. Okay, I'm seeing messages from multiple people. Let me try to scan the questions now if other people are still here. Okay, I see there's a lot. I'm getting pinged here. Can I continue talking, or do you need to close this team? Your question wasn't answered yet. Could you please retype it into this the chat now? Because right now I'm finally viewing it. Copy paste it or not into Skype, you can just into local chat. Anyone? Oh, if people asked about if you don't want to offer a newer version of your product, you don't have to offer a newer version. It's an option for you, the merchant. You can deliver a new product version, but you're not forced to. Well, because we have Kitely, that's our business entity. We don't have deep pockets to run multiple things. Our system allows us to start sandboxes on demand when needed, and do that in an economic way, so merchants will be able to upload content. And it made sense to do it that way. I don't see separating the grids as any issue. I'm sorry, thank you. Are there any other? Yeah, I'm joking.
The question was, if it's the goal is to make it a market for all grids, not biased towards Kitely, why not have chosen to use Kitely as a grid for creating the content and not just keep it separated from other content creation, separated on its own content creation world for selling on multiple grids? People can upload into, can create in another grid and upload into the free access sandbox and just use that. They never have to travel Kitely, they're going to have to use Kitely, they just need to get it into Kitely. Currently, we don't enable IAR uploads, so there's the only way is via a viewer. But eventually, if we allow that, you'll just upload IAR, and so it's you won't even have to go in world ever to upload your content into the car marketplace. Okay, are there other questions I did not answer? If so, please do copy-paste them into the chat. Yeah, I didn't see, the question was, did we see it as a competitive advantage? No, it's our goal was to build a marketplace. We think the marketplace is a viable business all by its own. We leveraged Kitely because it existed and allowed us to offer various things for free that we couldn't otherwise. But it's we're not charging people to access the sandboxes. They don't have to get anything from on Kitely. They don't have to buy our credits. And it just allowed us to leverage the technology that we had. People can upload, well, they can upload content via OR file into a world. They could do it via OR. You can upload content into Kitely when you create a new world. You have a free world, so you can easily upload an OR into your world. But then it's not in your inventory. The market takes content from your inventory, so you'd have to go in the world, and you can do that. There's a 2-3 hours a month that you get with the free plan on Kitely. So you can upload OR, resin world, take it into your inventory, disconnect, and then it's basically you upload it via OR, took it into your inventory in Kitely, and then use the Kitely market interface to upload that into your product listings. Okay, he says, I think that is just the reason most are opposed, because it seems like you said, think you're king, just because you guys decided to use your own grid. Okay. As I explained, we opened a service that was not available and that requires resources to run. We're not aware of other grids provide unlimited resources that we can leverage to build the missing components that are part of the upload and testing procedure. That is something that we added. We don't force anyone to use Kitely to do this. They don't have to be a Kitely user. They don't have to pay us. So the only thing is like going into Second Life, into a sandbox, and using that to upload content that you sell into Second Life Marketplace. Is that a competitive advantage for Second Life? I don't see it as that selling them more land. Okay. You said no, I am agreeing with you. Okay, other questions? I'm just saying it is a reason people might act opposed because it seems that way, but you guys never thought that. It just happened to be that way. Yes, Timothy, that's exactly true. It's not our goal to leverage this for competitive advantage. We're completely fine if all the grids users stay on those grids and just use Kitely markets. We're completely happy with that. It would be good for both the grids themselves. They get more revenue that they didn't get otherwise. And it will be good for Kitely. We get the marketplace revenue, and everyone profits. We don't need to get the revenue from renting regions. It's
it's a separate business, and their existence that doesn't rely on one another. It's simply that we leverage whatever we could to create the Kitely market. As it is, it took extremely a lot of resources to build. As you know, Arne Hurwitz is extremely talented, and he's been working on this for 9 months. And this is, if you look, we built an Amazon, basically, which is quite an undertaking. It behaves well. We've tested it with a lot, under a lot of load. It's a big technological endeavor to do. So we had to leverage whatever we could to get it done as quickly as possible. He says, my only worry is about the taking back features that you guys would need database access to grids you share with. Currently it doesn't exist on Kitely as well. We store the data that we can use to do that eventually. Right now, the only thing is we prevent that data from being exportable. So if there's a chargeback or some dispute, then we have to not deliver the money to the merchant because it's still on the 45-day dispute window. Then we block the content from leaving country, make it no export. So it doesn't matter if it's an inventory or a rest or some given to other person, it's going to remain no export. So that's the only thing that's currently implemented. But this data will allow us eventually to provide this take-back functionality inside of Kitely. Exactly like hypergrid access, if we develop a mechanism that you can install on your end, on your own grid, it will be something that you elect to do. It won't be something that's required. And merchants will just know whether they'll have require or not allow the existence of this plugin in order to consider a grid to be secure or not. That will be just one of their options. It's up to the merchants where they want to sell. As we said, we can't force them to sell in other places. But if they will offer, we're trying to make it so that we'll offer other grids whatever benefits we can export from our own technology, so they'll be able to run them in their own grids. And they'll decide whether they want to install them or not. We can't force merchants, we can't force grid owners, we can just give options. But if it's already on said grid X, it is stuck there. Right now, yeah, it's stuck there. We don't have any access to them. Hypergrid delivery means delivery. It doesn't mean we have access to your database. We considered doing a module. He asked perhaps you guys could do like Hypergrid Exchange and do a model. But a module requires everyone to install something. And that we felt required a lot more trust with other grid owners. It would create a lot of hurdles. We wanted something that, someone with SIM on a stick just installed it at home and wants to get content, and that's an easy sell for a merchant. This is someone new to OpenSim. We wanted that person to be able to just run SIM on a stick or inside their grid that might be behind a firewall and might have issues with running some company's module. We wanted them to be able to just use hypergrid access, which is something that you can even configure. You even use a GUI tool that provided with various SIM distribution. And basically do that without removing as many hurdles as possible. So a module could work, but it would create a lot more barriers to adoption. And we feel that if we want to create the biggest market we can, is that we need to be able to give anyone access to this. And Hypergrid allows us to do that. Additional question? All right, then in that respect, many find even New World Studio complicated. Exactly. We wanted to make it easy for people to buy content, so merchants will have an easy time to sell content, and then money will get into the system, investors will invest, and this entire ecosystem will grow and will have much more viable grids becoming attainable, because right now we're basically fighting over the few grids are fighting on users between themselves. And if we make OpenSim a big single ecosystem, then you have merchants coming in, you have content creators, you have users coming in, and the entire, you know, rising tide raises all boats. That's the goal, to help everyone grow, so this can be a much, not a pond, but a sea, but an ocean. Additional questions? And thank you, Sally and Jerry. Indeed, a lot of innovative thinking and work in Codus to Pack. Thank you, Sally. Timothy continues, I think the only grid that fight for users or closed grids, hypergrid, is just find your home, visit all. I tend to agree, but we want to be able to service anyone. I think a lot of closed grids have, if you look at the total size of OpenSim, there are quite a few people still on closed grids, and we want to be able to allow merchants to sell them as well, and basically join forces with those grids to make the ecosystem bigger, so we're not this OpenSim or hypergrid-enabled universe and the closed grids. We want to all of us to be together one addressable market, and closed grids can remain closed. They just have to create an exception for a tightly market delivery mechanism. But if we close all, if we connect all of us together, then we're a much more interesting, much more interesting for everyone, for users, for merchants, for investors, for businesses, and this becomes viable. And we're all investing so much time on our grids, as users, as merchants, as businesses, that we shouldn't fight amongst each other. We should join forces and move forward. He says, and I think that is a wonderful idea. Thank you, Timothy. In a theory, convincing people is the hard part. I agree. That's why I spent a lot of time basically addressing various issues that have raised. Since this has been streamed and our slides will go up on the web. I haven't uploaded them yet, but they'll go up on the web as well. So hopefully some people will be able to move past the fear, uncertainty, and disinformation, and get part, get to the part where it's actually good for everyone. And some will get it, some will not. Hopefully enough will that we can start creating momentum, and we all benefit from it. Okay, any other questions? Okay, I'm not hearing any typing, so I'll guess we'll wrap it up for tonight. Is there someone typing? You still plan on offering the disabled use of effects? It is really slowed down on browser. We do. He previously asked about us disabling the various animations that we like, but there are problematic if people with older viewers or older computers, older browsers, sorry, or older computers who are, or people with disabilities. And so, yes, we do intend to add that feature. It will be in the settings tab, where in settings page, where you'll be able to disable the animations. Okay, so that was the last one. So I guess we're wrapped up for tonight. And again, please do contact me if you have any questions, doubts, concerns, ideas, or if you just want to ask about the weather. My name is Ilan Tochner, email ilan@kitely.com, kitely.com. And that's a wrap up.